Beginning this evening with youth violence on the Central Coast. In the last few months alone, there has been a long string of shootings involving teens, many deadly, many gang-related. And now one county is trying to take some proactive steps to stop it all. Action News reporter Margot Dunphy has more live from our Salinas newsroom. It's our top story.
Dan, turning the curve on youth violence is what this forum is called, and it's the vision of Watsonville Police Chief Manny Solano, who wanted the voice of young people to be heard when dealing with this issue.
Just a week after a 15-year-old boy is shot in a drive-by on the streets of Santa Cruz, a conference to address the growing problem of youth crime.
The youth have helped organize this, and that the youth are here listening and to take these messages out to their friends.
Turning the curve on youth violence brought together educators, youth leaders, and law enforcement Friday to collaborate on solutions and crime prevention in Santa Cruz County.
Well, services from educational programs, treatment programs, intervention programs, trying to get involved in the community, the educational piece of it, so that we can attack these problems head on.
It was also a chance for young people to speak out. Yoni Hernandez is still a gang member, but believes that allows him better access to the kids he can help.
Someone that knows the experience of being in a gang, helping another gang member, is kind of more easier than somebody that doesn't have experience.
As well as telling his story at the event, he hoped to learn more about how to help change the lives of troubled kids in his community.
And not tell them not to get out of the gang, because that's not going to happen, but like kind of like help them and give them like the tools, the right tools to help them to have a better education and like to pursue something in high school, in college.
And today's forum will help to develop a comprehensive plan for youth violence prevention. Participants today also got some insight into how they can get involved in its implementation. Dan?
All right. Thank you very much, Margot. Meantime, a nationwide effort to get gang members off the streets has ended now with 361 arrests in 71 cities. That operation ran between July and August.